Now tell us about the book awards that you're judging.
I know, it's terrific, isn't it?
Yeah.
Costa Booker Awards. I like the Costas because I think they're more about finding books that are really readable and fun. And my, you know, judging them is being really extraordinarily difficult because you're pitching a poetry book against a first novel, against a children's book, against a novel, and a, you know, all different things.
And you have to read, don't you?
And you're supposed to be able to say which is the best.
Yeah, you know? I remember judging, it wasn't that one, but judging a book thing. And I went, yeah, I'd love to do that. And then 26 books arrived. How many did you have to read?
No, because this is the final. I've only had to read six.
Right.
Five, okay. Five. And it's been wonderful because I've just been on holiday in the Maldives. And can you imagine anything nicer than the Maldives and a stack of six books?
No, I can't.
Yeah. No. That is just heaven.
Although, I think, actually, the only thing nicer would be the Maldives and cake. So I'm sure if you could get the Bake Off...
We got cake, too.
Yeah, OK. If you could get Bake Off to move to the Maldives, then you're sorted. Then you're sorted.
No, that would be work.
Yeah, because you write books, don't you?
And I do novels.
You do novels, yeah.
I've got a new one coming up. Can I give it a quick plug?
Yeah. Sure.
It's going to be called The Lost Son.
Okay.
And it comes out in April. And it's the third of a trilogy.
Okay.
So,
do you like writing? Do you find writing relaxing or is it a bit of a chore?
No, I love it. Yeah. I absolutely love it. I love it when I get into it. It's like all these things. Mm. You sort of do 100 things to instead. Displacement activity, I think it's called.
Yeah.
And then when you finally get stuck in, it's great.
Yeah.
But I do. I think the interesting thing about judging books, which is what I've been doing with Acosta, is I'm always looking for books that have characters that you really sympathise with or that you understand. Even if you hate them, you understand them.
Yeah.
And you want to have a story that is somehow satisfying. It doesn't matter to me if it's a happy ending, although I do quite like happy endings, or it's not. What I can't bear is an unsatisfactory you guess.
Yes,
ending.
No. I want to know.
It's got to be satisfying.
Yeah.
And I think that's what the Costa's after. They're after books that you really love to read and that you want to give to other people to read.
Now, I picked up on a couple of words that you said there. You want it to be satisfying, you want to you know, enjoy it even if you don't necessarily like them. That kind of sums up your Great British Bake Off guest list that you've got that I've got here in front of you. It's a Stand Up To Cancer special, and you've got some amazing people that have got on board.
Well, it isn't really different for Paul and me because we are just looking for the best bake.
Okay.
We genuinely are. We still want it to be really good baking. But the truth is that some of those celebrities are useless at baking. I mean, they're absolutely lovely, and of course they're not chosen for their baking skills. They're chosen because they're great fun to watch. And some of them surprise themselves at how good they are.
Yeah.
Because they, you know, not bake much, and then they get very competitive, and they really try, and some of them go practice before. Some of them, I have to say, arrive in the tent having hardly read the brief, not quite sure why they're there.
I'd be useless.
And they just are completely lost.
I have to, because I don't want to run out of time without asking you this, because it's something I'm very interested in now. You're married, but you live separately from your husband. I'm loving this idea.
Well, I have to say this is a slight press exaggeration. I mean, we live together in my house, in the sense that we sleep in my house every night. But the best thing is that he still has his house, and that's where all his stuff is.
Yeah! I like that. And that's great.
It's even better than that, because when we wake up in the morning, he makes the cup of tea and I get it in bed, and then he goes off to his house and cleans the shoes, including mine.
I like that very much.
You've done well.
I mean, that's better than a dog.
Brilliant.
He is
just
absolutely.
As well trained.
But you know, he doesn't have any sort of gender rubbish. Yeah. You know, he doesn't mind carrying my handbag if I'm struggling with it, or you know, he's
the perfect man.
He's a confident guy who isn't screwed up about.
And was this a conversation that it's happened really organically? You know, we're going to get married, but actually the living arrangements will just kind of stay as they are.
Yeah, exactly, because we're both too old and too Set we've both got ways. Too much stuff. If you hit my age, you have too much clobber. And then imagine me having to move half of my clobber out of the house to let in half of his.
Oh, no.
And anyhow, he's the most untidy man you ever met, and I'm rather sort of neat and tidy and organising. So it would be awful if his stuff was there.
I'm going to sell this idea to my husband tonight.
I like it. I'm sure it doesn't work.